Good morning, all of you. Today we'll learn the numerical integration methodology. Now we'll study the chapter of numerical integration. Numerical integration. Okay. Now, whenever we listen the word that is integration, what do you mean by the integration? Now there are two terminologies are there. One is the differentiation and second one is the integration. Okay, now integration generally in 12th standard we have studied something this type of, for example, integration of f of x dx having a limits from x0 to xn. If you want to take a more practical example, I can write integration of sine x dx having a limit from 0 to pi. Now what does it mean, integration? Now integration means it is area under the curve. Now suppose I had drawn plotted a curve of x versus f of x. Okay, suppose this is the curve and what are the limits are there? That is x0 to xn. x0 to xn. Whatever the area under this curve is there, this area under this curve is, this area is nothing but our integration. Now we want to evaluate this integration. We want to evaluate the integration of 0 to pi having a limit from sine 0 to pi of sine x. Now how to evaluate this integration? In 12th standard we have studied. Now what to do? That is, limits are being given, that is 0 to pi. Okay, what I will do? We will find out sine of 0 and we will find out sine of pi. Now find out in your calculator sine of 0 and sine of pi. Provided that your calculator should be in the right node. Always remember, in our subject of numerical methods and optimization, your calculator should be in the radian mode. Just calculate it, sine of 0. What is the answer of sine of 0? That is, sine of 0 is nothing but equal to 0. And sine of pi, again it is 0. Sine of pi is also 0. Now again evaluate sine of pi by 2. That is sine of pi by 2. How much is the answer? Means pi means it is 180 degree, pi by 2 means it is 90 degree. Sine of pi by 2 is equal to 1. Now we'll plot this curve. Let us plot this curve. That is 0, then pi by 2, and this is pi. Now what type of curve I will get? Sine of 0 is equal to 0, sine of pi by 2 is 1, and sine of pi is equal to 0. We'll get this type of curve. This curve, again I can say this is a 3 pi by 2, and I can further find out it is a 2 pi. Further I will get this curve. Now this is a positive domain and this is a negative domain. Okay, now if you have done the addition of these two domains, okay, then you will get the total area under the curve from limit from 0 to 2 pi. Okay, now we understood how we have done in the 12th standard. Now we want to develop some numerical method for that. Now what are the different methods are available for the evaluation of a such integration? Now let us see. We'll see that is the classification of numerical integration, or in simple language we can say it is a integration. Now how to classify the integration? Now it is broadly classified into the two category. That is, the first category says it is a Newton's quote method. First category, it is Newton's quotes method, and second category, it is the Gauss-Legendre's formula. Second category, Gauss-Legendre formula. Okay, now this Newton quotes method, again it is being developed by the scientist, that is Newton. Now this is being classified into the different category. It is dependent on what is the polynomial of degree we are going to use. If we are going to use polynomial of degree 1, polynomial of degree 1. What do you mean by the polynomial of degree 1? It is the equation of a straight line. It is the equation of a straight line. Then methodology suitable for this type of problem is nothing but our trapezoidal rule. Methodology suitable is nothing but trapezoidal rule. Second classification is nothing but if we are going to use polynomial of degree 2. Polynomial of degree 2. Degree 2 means it is a quadratic equation. Quadratic equation means it is in the form ax square plus bx plus c. For this type of curve, we can use that is the Simpson's 1/3 rule. Simpson's 1/3 rule. Then third classification is nothing but polynomial of degree 3. Polynomial of degree 3, that is cubic curve. That is cubic curve. Then for this type of problem, we can use that is the Simpson's 3/8 rule. We can use Simpson's 3/8 rule. Then further, we are having further more methodologies are available. If you are going to use polynomial of degree 6. Degree 6 means it is a 6 degree curve. 6 degree curve. Then we can use, there are different methodologies are there, that is we can use the Wedel's rule. We can use the Wedel's rule. But this methodology is not part of your syllabus, therefore you don't worry about this method. Then second one, it is the Gauss-Legendre formulas are there. There are two formulas are there, that is Gauss-Legendre two point formula and 3-point formula. Now if you have seen, your syllabus is restricted to the trapezoidal rule, that is the polynomial of degree 1, that is straight line, polynomial of degree 2, that is 1/3 rule, then polynomial of degree 3, that is Simpson's 3/8 rule. This is not part of your syllabus, but just only for your sake of knowledge. Then Gauss-Legendre's formula, 2-point formula and 3-point formula. Now this is only your syllabus of numerical integration. Now we'll study each and every method in the details. Okay, thank you.